Centralia man who grew up without his father is now inspiring others through his comedy show on YouTube. Gus and Pops is about a father and son who use laughter to help bridge the gap they had for years. Now, after 18 years of being apart, Gus used a fake lottery ticket to bring love and laughter into their relationship. His mission was simple, to give his father a second chance. Here to share his story is Gus Moss himself. Good morning. Thank you for joining us. So I love that you're Southern Illinois born, and so you've done quite a bit in your time here in the last couple of years. But tell us about the fake lottery ticket story. I'm sure there's more to it than I was able to share.
In all reality, I just didn't have that relationship with my father as I should have as a kid. And I just wanted to bring a relationship to him. I just wanted to have a love. And as a kid, I wanted to fill that void up. And I didn't know anything else to do. So I said, you know what? I've been goofy my whole life. So what can I do to bring this back together? So I went and got a lottery ticket, and I told my dad that he won $5,000, and I video recorded it, and it went viral, and it brought a lot of attention to people. But I wanted people to know, in doing that, I found something that as a kid I never had, and I was just looking for that love. I was looking for that father figure in my life, and I had a father figure in my life, but I always wanted to know who my real father was, and I didn't care how long it took or what I had to go through to get it. I just wanted to show him that I do care, and I do appreciate everything that she was doing for me or trying to do for me as a kid.
And what many may not know, you also played quite a bit of basketball in your career, right? College basketball, and you played at Rinn Lake as well, right?
Yes, no, I coached at Rinn Lake.
Yes. Okay, so you've done quite a bit, and you've been able to use that as a platform to help young people as well, right?
Just giving them another way out, another outlet. I mean, you may not be the next Michael Jordan or the next Kobe Bryant, but if you have the knowledge and the resources to do the things that they were able to do, then we may see those people make it. And I just want to give them, don't want to shut them out on all the things that I was able to grow on and learn from as a kid from the older people. So I just give that back to the younger kids, and that's what older people should do.
And another thing that when I was kind of researching some of your story of you and Gus and Pops, yourself and Pops, I also learned that you were kind of using this when you speak to young people as a way to kind of not allow the things that upset you to separate you from people. And I thought that was really good for young people to hear.
And that's probably the best thing in all of this. I never shut them out of my life. No matter our imperfections, no matter my imperfections or my mother's imperfections, I gave him that second chance, and I gave him his flowers while he could still smell them. And I just wanted him to know that I don't care why you wasn't there. And as a kid, I hated him. I hated him. I'd sat in the room and I cried and I wondered where he was at. I played in over 2,000 basketball games my whole life, and my dad only came to one game my whole life. And I was 32 years old when he did that. And that was the biggest moment of my life, when he was able to walk in that gym and I could see him. And that means more to me than anything. And it's not the time lost. It's all about what we can do now and just live in the moment and cherish every time that we have, because we all have to go one day.
I 100% agree with that. Thank you so much. And we'll have more on our website about Gus and Pops and their comedy on YouTube. So thank you so much.